Jai Hind everyone. Now the students, today we are going to start with the second chapter of economics, that is people as resource. What's the name of the chapter? People as resource. Now in the first period we dealt with few of the factors of production like land, labor, capital, and last, that is human capital. Now why are we discussing all these factors here in this chapter, people as resource? We have also dealt with some of the topics like what are the production activity, what is the input, what is output, what is physical capital, what is working capital. So what is the use of all these things here, we shall be dealing with later on. Now here in this topic, people as resource, you can see there are two terms, people and resource. So before dealing with this chapter, we are going to understand that what does these two terms mean. What do you mean by people here and what do you mean by resource here? People here refers to population. People here refers to population, that is Indian population and as a whole. So we are referring here that the Indian population and that too as a whole. We are not talking about any sample population, okay? Now this term you understood, people, that is population, and that too Indian population and that too as a whole. What does resource mean? We have already learned about resources, what are the kinds of resources in first chapter, like whatever the resources we are having, human resource we are having, some natural resources we are having. But here what does it mean? It means that anything which can be transformed into benefit. Okay, resource, anything which can be transformed into benefit. Transformed means change. Here transformed means change. Now benefit, now why are we talking about benefit here? Benefit we are talking about in the context of population. How, as we all know that Indian population is too much, we all know that, and because of this we are also, you know, facing so many problems out here. You can take the example of unemployment, poverty, even the many kind of exploitation are also there. So now this is our responsibility. We are going to understand this thing through this chapter, that how are we going to take benefit from the huge population of India. Like we are having huge population and we are also having its we are also aware with its negative effects. Negative effects means like exploitation of natural resources, unemployment is there, then illiteracy is also there. So now sometimes we overlook the importance of this huge Indian population. Now students, we are going to understand this, how can we take maximum benefit from this Indian population, how can we convert. The big question is that how can we convert this population into benefit. Here benefit means asset. Right now what we consider is our Indian population is a liability. Indian population is liability. Liability means what? Liability means burden. According to us, whenever we talk about Indian population, it only one word comes to our mind, that is liability. So in this whole chapter we are going to study that how can we convert Indian population from liability to an asset. Asset means Asset means boon, means benefit. How can we convert that? This is a big question. What are the things where we can invest to convert Indian population from liability to an asset? Now, students, for an example, I'm giving you a few examples on your basis only. Like, you are a student right now. For you, right now, you are an asset or a liability for your parents. Yes, you are a liability for your parents. Why? Because you are not contributing anything in economic development or economic growth. Whatever your parents are doing, they are investing on you. You are not contributing anything. They are investing on your health. They are investing on your education. They are making you self-sufficient so that in near future, you would be an asset to your family. This is the example I have taken as individual, basis on the individual. Like every individual, a person who is acquiring education, a person who is acquiring training, a person who is blessed with good medical facilities, that particular person from here or from there, whatever it is, in near future, that particular person is going to be an asset for his own family, after that society, community, and later on for the country. So every individual's, whatever the individual's growth is there, it for the individual first, then for the society, community, and then for the country, and but obvious economy. So now, for an example, investment, I used one word investment here. What do you mean by an investment? Investment is an act of investing your time, your effort, and money. Means when you are putting your effort, when you are putting your time, when you are putting your money into something just to have profit, just to have advantage, and just to have benefit from that particular thing. Being a student, you are putting your, right now you are putting your time, you are putting your effort just to score good marks. Okay, this is your investment, where your father, he, your parents investing money on you. Why? So that you can be, you can have a, means he, they can have a better individual, they can have a better person, you people can have a better person for a country, not only for the country but for the your personal growth, for society growth, and later on for the economic growth as well. Because when you are medically, if you are educated, if you are medically fit, then but obvious that it will be an asset for you. Okay, so now the question I asked, that how can we convert our Indian population from liability to an asset? We need to invest in three things. What are those three things? First is education. Second is medical care. And the last one is, that is training. Just now I gave you example as an example for you as a student only. Now I am going to give you example one. Suppose if there is any fisherman, okay, you are going to teach that fisherman how to fish. Okay, and if that particular person acquires this skill, I use the word skill. When you train someone, a person acquires with a specific skill, and when a person uses that skill to earn something, that will be turned into a profit. It means that you are not only teaching him how to fish, indirectly you are teaching him so that he could earn something, he would do something for his own family, he would do something for his society, for community, and for the, indirectly for the country. By that means, but obvious, his skills will improve and he will become more productive, and he will become more productive. So these are the key concept in this thing. Like, once you are going to invest in these three things, education, medical care, and training, a particular person, a particular individual, definitely his skills are going to enhance. Next, he will become more productive. Let's take another example. There is a man in a factory. Okay, initially he was manufacturing 5 shirts. Okay, 5 shirts. Now after that, after some kind of training he gets and some kind of like education he have some kind of education and some training, he able to produce, instead of 5 shirts, he able to produce 10 shirts. Okay, so now initially when he was manufacturing 5 shirts at the rate of ₹100 per shirt, at that time his profit was 500 on 5 shirts. When he get education, when he get training, he able to produce 10 shirts and that too ₹1,000. Now see, can you find any difference here? 5 shirts, 500 total profit at the rate of ₹100 per shirt. Next, after getting proper training and education, 10 shirts and he is getting ₹1,000 means per shirt, means it means that his profit will be of ₹500. It means that he would be able to become more skilled and he would be able to become more productive by 500, and he would be able to increase more profit by ₹500. So now this is the only importance of education, medical and training. Now this is an example of education and training, it's a synopsis form. Now I'm giving you the medical. Now just see, can anybody tell me that, suppose if you are being a student, I just take example from you only, being a student, if you are unhealthy, can you put 100% effort in whatever the hard work you are doing? No, you cannot. Because if you are unhealthy, you cannot put anything, you cannot be efficient whatever you are doing. So for the same example here also, if you are talking about this man who would be able to produce 5 shirts initially, later on 10 shirts, and him able to make a profit of ₹500. If he is medically unfit, do you think that he would be able to produce that much of shirts and he would be able to make that much of profit? No. It means that here, if he is not medically fit or medically unfit, then it means that his productivity also hamper, his skills also hamper, and he cannot devote his time, devotion, whatever it is, like you can say 100%. Means whatever effort he is investing in his effort, and he is putting his time, he is putting his effort, it's not 100%. So for that, medically fit, healthy person is most important. Unhealthy person is liability for a country. Healthy person is an asset for a country. Now, this is the synopsis that we are going to deal. Now, how are we going to relate with this, the population? Population, why? Because, you know, for an example, I just tell you an example, Japan. Let me take the example of Japan. Why Japan is like, it's a rich and developed country. What are the things which made Japan rich and developed country? Hear all these three things. How? Just see. Japan government, they invested in human resource through education and medical care. Education means proper education. They invested education, human resource through education and medical. They have taken utmost care of medical and education, human resource. Secondly is that they have also taken the efficient use of other resources. Other resources means land and capital. You know what? We have studied 4 factors of production: land, labor, capital and human capital. So can you tell me that out of these 4 things, which factor of production is most important? Yes, it's human capital. Why human capital? Because it is the only human capital which are going to take efficient use of these other resources. Alone land cannot do anything. Alone capital cannot do anything. Alone labor cannot do anything if he is not skilled. So human capital, your knowledge, your experience, your education, whether you are medically, whether you are healthy or you are unhealthy, all these factors collectively make proper efficient use of human resource. In India also, we have human resource, but they are not skilled. They are not productive. So just to make them skilled and just to make them productive, we need to invest in all these three things: education, medical and training. Now see how, just take an example of, I'm the second example of role of education. What is the role of education? Role of education is like, it creates lots of opportunity, okay? It brings confidence in you. Secondly, it makes the country's growth, you can say, takes the next level to a country's growth. Not only country's growth, society growth, individual growth, everything. Now, role of education, suppose if a person is educated, I am just taking it of a two person example, if one person is educated and one person is not educated, that particular person has many opportunities as compared to uneducated. Why? Because he cannot use his experience, he cannot use his knowledge, and whereas a person who is educated, he can use his experience, he can use his knowledge, whatever he learns during his education process, to be a better individual, and with that, if he would invest in that, he would be a better citizen also. He would help in contributing economic growth, country's growth, economic growth, in everything. Second, that is medical care. It's utmost important. Medical care is utmost important. Why? Because we have already discussed, unhealthy person is liability for a country and healthy person is asset for a country. So we need to take care of health also. We have to be healthy, we have to be fit to work, because it increases our efficiency, it will enhance our skills, it will make a person more productive, and we would be able to do more work as it is required. Next is training. Apart from education, apart from medical care, training is also utmost important. Suppose for any unskilled labor, if you cannot, person cannot pursue education, if anyone can train that person, for an example, we have just taken the example of fisherman. If you are teaching fisherman how to fish, but obviously you are giving him some amount of training, so by that training he would be able to earn something, he would be able to earn profit, he would be able to make a profit for his own family, for his individual, for his own family, for the country. So like this, if we can make, if we are going to invest in human resource in our population, which is large in number, then you can understand, this way we are going to help in country's development, and if we are going to help in country's development, definitely economic growth will also be there, national income will also generate, national income will also be there. So first we have to start with the people, first we have to start with the population, because country, community and society, who makes all these things? Only people makes all these things. And if the people are not efficient, if they are not educated, if they are not properly trained, if they are not medically fit, but obviously it's going to hamper country's growth, it's going to hamper society's growth, indirectly it's going to hamper firstly individual's growth. Once individual will grow, then only a society will grow, country will grow, and definitely economic will also grow. So the next topic we are going to deal in the next class. Thank you very much.